happy news. Coming to you live in Darvet. Bye.
Good morning, ARB Stallions. And we are back with another week of ARB News with Wiz and my co-host, Natasha.
Now let's start off with interesting facts of East Square.
Hello, this is E-Square with me, Edwin.
Me, Ezekiel.
Today in LA local news, Governor Gavin Newsom will be ending the indoor mask mandate on February 15. However, the unvaccinated will still have to wear masks indoors. LA County health officials have announced that they will keep their mask mandate way past the state deadline and instead look at their own numbers and see when to end their own mask mandate. The mandate will now allow guests visiting nursing homes and hospitals to no longer require a negative COVID test. LA County health officials will look into what to do with the virus when it finally hits below 2,500 cases for 7 straight days. And they're also still looking into whether to allow masks in schools for children. On to the fun fact.
Well, that's certainly something to inspect, but for today's fun fact, do you guys know that that lightning is capable of forming a sphere? Ball lightning, as it's commonly referred to, is a rare aerial phenomenon in which lightning forms into a luminous sphere in the ground. It can range from a variety of colors, including red, orange, yellow, white, or blue. Its cause in relation to common lightning are unknown, but among the suggested explanations are air and gas behavior abnormally, high air density, plasma behavior, an air vortex containing luminous gases, and microwave radiation trapped within a plasma bubble.
Now let's go to shoutouts for Ellie and Mary.
Shout out to my advisory for always doing their best to be inclusive, kind, and positive. Another shout out to my advisees that turned in a permission slip for the hike. Although we didn't all get to go, I want to recognize your willingness to get outdoors.
I would also like to give a shout out to my advisees, Daniel, Roberto, Chelsea, Aurora, and Erica for hiking their little hearts out in the last hike. Lastly, shout out to my environmental science students for doing the cognitive work to ensure that our community receives environmental justice. From Ms. Castañeda Flores.
Shout out to my advisory students, the champs, because all of you guys are on track to graduate. You guys are the best advisory ever. From Ms. Marin.
If you want to give your teacher or student a shout-out, send it to the following email, bunchynews2022@gmail.com.
Hi, and I'm here with a special guest, Ms. King, and she has a special shout-out. So, Ms. King, would you like to take the floor?
Yes. Now, okay, so I'm going to shout-out my entire advisory. I'm going to say everyone's name, okay, so bear with me. Shout-out to Natalie, Carla, Patty, Elizabeth, Brittany, Josue, Saul, Andres, Christian, Ivan, Robert, Yareni, Yaravitsi, Delilah, Sherry, Jesus, Johan, Javier, Henry, and Sophia. Shout out to being the best advisory. And I hope we can still pay attention in reading and do great in all our classes like we have been, right?
Okay, well, thank you, Mrs. K, for that warm and big, nice shout out that you just gave us. And we'll be closing this out now that we have wrapped this all up. We'll see you next week with shout outs.
Stay in the loop with ARB updates.
Here's our stallion update. We're having COVID testing Wednesday, February 9, advisory green and yellow, and Thursday, February 10, advisory pink and purple. Next, we're having our minimum day on February 11. We're coming out at 12:55. Then, our last, our Bunch of Love Festival on February 24th.
Hi, my name is Phil Pridemore. I teach music production with ARC. If you like singing, if you're into rapping, you want to learn to make beats, you want to learn how to DJ, or just self-expression, this is a class you want to be in. If you play guitar, if you play drums, anything, all across the board, these are things that we learn and do inside the class. We have toys, drum machines, microphones, small DJ controllers, big DJ controllers, Either way, let's take a look over here. We got a student making beats right now. We've got MIDI keyboards. Anything it takes to make beats, this is what we do in the class. Some of the classes inside, some of the classes off campus. We go work concerts, city events. Take 15 minutes, come say hi. We're here every single Wednesday after school.
Hi, my name is Ms. Alvaran. I am the art teacher at Animal Ralph Bunch. And I would like to invite you to come join us every Wednesday after school from 3:45 until 4:45. We meet up, we do critiques for each other's work of art. We work with quilling, we work with plexiglass, paint, collaging. You guys are welcome to come in whenever you like. And again, even if you are not an art student, if you're not in the 11th grade, but you still want to join the Animal Voices competition, that's a competition that goes on every year. Everyone is welcome to join. Bye, everyone.
Now we'll move on to 10 second trivia. Guess the answer right and you'll be on top like the ceiling, right?
It's trivia time! In which continent are Chile, Argentina, and Brazil? A, South America, B, Australia, C, Europe, or D, North America? The answer is South America. Congratulations to those who got it right. Here's an extra question. When and where was Ralph Bunch born? Please submit your responses to bunchynews2022@gmail.com for advisory points.
Now moving on to the weather. Bundle up in the cold air will feel like spring warm weather.
On Tuesday, we'll have a sunny day with a high of 79 and a low of 64. On Wednesday, we'll have a sunny day with a high of 88 and a low of 52. On Thursday, we'll have a sunny day with a high of 86 and a low of 55. On Friday, we'll have a high of 84 and a low of 54. On Saturday, we'll have a sunny day with a high of 84 and a low of 54.
Today's fun fact. Did you know that every second about 100 lightning bolts strike Earth?
Now moving on to TikToks and the club will make your hips rock. To fake right and break left, watch out for the pick and keep an eye on the fence. Gotta run the give and go, take the ball to the hole, and don't be afraid to shoot the outside, Jay. Just keep your head in the game, just keep your head in the game, and don't be afraid to shoot the outside, Jay. Just keep your head in the game. Gotta get your head in the game.
This time we hit the right note. Senegal wins their first ever international trophy against Egypt in the AFCON in penalties. The boys' soccer team gets the win against Annenberg after Annenberg playing with a red card player, with these ARBs keeping their winning streak with now 7 wins in a row.
Good luck to the boys' soccer team for having a game later today against Orthopedic at 2. Shout out to the boys and girls basketball team for having a game later today against Animal Watts. Good luck!
The boys soccer team has a game tomorrow at 3:30 at Russ Snyder. Go show some support going after school.
Hey Stallion, so who's ready for the Super Bowl this weekend, February 13 at 3:30?
Now spreading cheese made the only fact to show on business.
Chesley Chris died at the age of 30. She was the winner of the 2019 Miss USA pageant. Her Miss USA pageant victory in 2019 marked a historic first when winners of America's 3 biggest beauty pageants were all black women. Chesley was also an attorney who worked for unjustly jailed inmates. New York City police confirmed that Chris's body was discovered on Sunday, January 30, 2022. Her death was an apparent suicide. Moses Mazzelli was an actor for The Walking Dead. He had been missing for 3 days until his body was recovered. He was found dead in his car in Stockbridge on January 26. The car doors were locked. He had a gunshot wound and a gun was found on his lap. This led to believe it was suicide. His family doesn't believe it was a suicide. Tassel, who has known him for years, also finds it hard to believe that the 31-year-old may have died in that manner. Anyone who knows Moses, the first thing they say is there's no way that kid committed suicide. Not in a million years, Tassel said. He was not depressed. He was not suffering from mental health issues. He was just happy, Tassel said. Shay announced she's pregnant with her second child on Monday, February 7th. The former Pretty Little Liars star announced her pregnancy on Instagram. The actress recently lost her best friend, Anne Graham. The actress Shay captioned the photo saying goodbye to a loved one while simultaneously experiencing the joy of welcoming another into this world is the great cycle of life. Kylie Jenner had her baby. Kylie's baby was born on February 2nd, a day after Stormy's birthday.
Now on to get to know your staff, who strive to make your future better than your past.
My name is Jose. I am the ARC site coordinator here at ARB.
How long have you been working at ARB?
This is my 4th year here at ARB.
If you had 3 wishes, what would you wish for?
I would wish for all the knowledge in the world, infinite happiness, and a stress-free life.
What was your fondest memory in your high school years?
My senior year, just because I was very closed off. 9th through 11th grade, and senior year I decided to join multiple sports and did a bunch of extracurriculars, so senior year.
What are your hobbies and how'd you get them?
I love playing sports. My favorite sport is soccer. I grew up playing since I was 5, but I play any sports.
Do you have any fun facts about you?
A couple years ago, I shattered my collarbone, so now I have 9 screws here, so that's a fun fact.
Okay. What would you rather throw away, love or money?
Money, because money can't buy you love.
Okay. Do you have any advice for high schoolers?
Enjoy it while you can. Have as much fun, but also have a plan for after high school.
We will be selling Valentine's Day grams Carrie Lynch from Tuesday to Friday.
Get it now, get it now, get it now, make it loud. Adios.